So, 9th standard students, very good morning and warm welcome to all of you. And now, social science, and we are going through the part geography. Unit geography we are going, and we are into the 5th chapter, that is land resources, Karnataka. In the previous video, we have done the introduction of what is of this one land. Then what is land utilization and how land utilization is getting done in Karnataka. Okay, so now today we will be starting with a new topic which is very important, that is agriculture. Okay, what is agriculture, how many types of agriculture, what are the crops which are, because agriculture is the base of this Karnataka. Okay, not Karnataka, in our country, because our country is an agricultural based country, so we have to focus on this one for our development as well as our need. So we will go with the introduction part. In the introduction part, what is there? The cultivation of land for raising crops is called agriculture. The cultivation of land, that means the actions or activities we are doing in the land to get the crops, that is known as agriculture. The cultivation of land for raising crops is called agriculture. Also, not only this raising of crops is agriculture, nowadays there are several other things are coming which are also regarded as the which are coming included in the agriculture. They are animal husbandry, poultry, beekeeping and sericultures are also included under agriculture. These are also the things which this sericulture and animal husbandry, you will get it in the keywords. Okay, so what is happened, the animal husbandry, poultry means this chicken and all farming, okay, eggs are coming, beekeeping for honey, sericultures are included under agriculture. Nearly 61.4% of the people in Karnataka are in rural areas. 61.4% of the people in Karnataka are in rural areas and they depend on agriculture for their livelihood. Okay, in the rural place, the main source of living is agriculture, and 61.4% of the rural people, they are in the rural of the rural people, they depend on this agriculture for their livelihood. Okay, so now we will go for the importance of agriculture. What are the importance of agriculture? Agriculture is one of the ancient primary occupation of Karnataka. Ancient primary occupation of Karnataka. It is the main source of livelihood, food. Out of our basic need, food, shelter and cloth. This comes every time as the first. Because without shelter or without this one, your cloth, you can survive. But without food, no living beings can be alive. Okay. It is the main source of livelihood. It is the backbone of our state's economy. It is the backbone of our state's economy. Not only our state's economy, it is the backbone of our country's economy. Okay. Of course, state comes under that. Agriculture provides food. What? For agriculture only we are getting the food. Employment to people. People are engaging there. They are getting some wages and all. So, this agriculture is giving employment to people. And raw material to industries. Several things are there which are sent to the industries for preparing something. So they are providing the raw material to the industries. Coffee, silk, spices, tobacco, cotton, etc. are the agricultural products which are exported. These are the things which are exported. And in Karnataka, what are they? Coffee, silk, silkworm, you know, spices, tobacco, cotton, etc. are the agricultural products which are exported. Agriculture helps in the tertiary occupation also. What is this tertiary occupation? It is going on, it is giving food, employment, etc. But for this, one more sector, that is the tertiary sector of the economy, they are also getting benefited. What is this tertiary sector? This tertiary sector is the transport, banking, insurance. Okay, see, in any economic activities, whatever it is, industry, it is agriculture, money is the main mode of transaction. So banking is getting benefited from agriculture, insurance will be there, people are making insurance for their, nowadays the insurance are there for the crops also. Okay, so though they are benefited, and these crops, they are shifted from one place to another. How the transport is getting benefited for that? It plays an important role in the political and social system of the state. Social system, of course, a person is getting money, his livelihood is getting high, standard of living is getting high, so it always affects the social life. Even the political life also is getting, political means, see, in this area, suppose this percentage of wheat has been produced, this percentage of ragi has been produced, means this is, the political also will be affected with the production of the agriculture. Now we will go for the types of agriculture. So what are the types of agriculture? Different types of agriculture crops grown according to the size of land. Size of land. Land fertility. How fertile the land is. Availability of water. How much water is there. Amount of rainfall. Climate. Physical features. Market facilities. Market facilities is a very important thing, because once you get the product, means the agricultural product, you have to sell it to the market. It's not that home to home or door to door you will go and you will be supplying these things. This will be going to a market. So a prominent market or fruitful market should be there, so that the farmers can sell their product easily and they should get a good return from there. The types of cultivations are classified according to these factors. What are the factors? Rainfall, climate, physical features, availability of water, size of land, land fertility, etc. Which are, as per this, what type of cultivations are there? That is subsistence farming, irrigation farming, dry farming, mixed farming, shifting farming, commercial farming and plantation farming. Okay, so first we will go with the subsistence farming. Okay, what is this subsistence farming? It's not written in a row. Okay, but where it is? Okay, we will go and we will do thing. Crops grown by, it is not subsistence farming. This is irrigation farming. What is irrigation farming? Crops grown by using water from canal, tanks or well is called irrigation farming. Means the crops which is grown with the help of the irrigation facility, that is known as irrigation, farming. Examples are paddy, sugarcane, etc. Okay, here it is, irrigation farming. Next is cultivation of crop which depends on rain is called dry farming. Okay, which depends mainly on rain, means that place no irrigation facilities are there, that is ragi, jowar, oil seeds, etc. Next is the cultivation of a few annual crops on larger state for the purpose of earning money is called plantation farming. Okay, where it is plantation farming? What is plantation farming? It is the cultivation of a few annual crop. They will not go for all the crops. Only few crops they will choose which are having some good market value, so that they can earn more money. So like coffee, tea, rubber, cocoa, these are the things which we can also export to other countries, so that we can get more income from these crops. Okay, next is crops that are grown not for the domestic market but for the international market is called commercial farming. Okay, there are some crops which are, the farmers made it, means they cultivate these crops only not for the domestic purpose, they made it for the export purpose, so that they can sell it internationally or globally. Tobacco, cotton, jute, etc. Example. crop which are grown by farmers for home consumption and not for market is called subsistence farming.
The first one,
subsistence farming. There are some crops which farmer grows it for their own consumption, not for the market. Okay, those are known as subsistence farming. It is an ancient type of farming. See, before this money introduced, people only focus what they can have food. That's all. Okay. So that time, this particular idea was that time there that. Nowadays, mixed type of farming is gaining popularity. In addition to crops, dairy farming, silkworm rearing, sheep rearing, poultry, beekeeping, fishery, etc. taken up, and it is called mixed farming. With the crops, dairy, poultry, everything is there. Where it is used like that, that is known as mixed farming. Okay. Then only one is left, I think. Yes, shifting cultivation. Farming system in which short period cultivations are followed with no crop on it for a season to restore its fertility. It means this one, shifting farming, this one, cultivation. I told you previously also that people do some cultivation for 6 months and another 6 months they will not do the cultivation, or they will do 1 year for cultivation and then again they will give a time break for 6 months only to restore the fertility of the soil. That type of cultivation is known as shifting cultivation. So now we have to go through the major crops of Karnataka. Only the introduction part I will tell you. Like different types of farming, there are different types of crops in Karnataka. Okay, different types of farmings are there, different types of crops are there. The main responsibility for this are soil, climate, relief features, irrigation facility, tradition of the farmers and the market for agricultural product, etc. The crops of Karnataka can be classified as. Crops of Karnataka are classified under three distinctive features, that is, one is food crops, that is paddy, ragi, maize, pulses, millets, etc. Next is commercial crops, sugarcane, cotton, tobacco, mulberry, oilseed, groundnut, sesam, sunflower, etc. Third one is the plantation crop, coffee, coconut, rubber, banana, etc. Okay, we will be tomorrow discussing regarding all these things once again. We will be starting from the major crops of Karnataka. Okay, thank you.